Now listen, would you like to say something to Peter on his 40th birthday?
Are you choosing ABP to say something nice about Peter?
Yes.
Well, I find it very difficult just spot on to think of anything nice to say about Peter. No, I don't seriously mean that. It's wonderful. I just learned that Dickie is 59 years of age, only 7 years younger than my wife. This is the most incredible thing, how you children are growing up.
It is.
How old must I be?
Well, wait, let's see those jeans. What happened to the jeans?
I had them all laundered, and Pauline insisted I wear this garb. Red.
Would you like to say happy birthday to Peter, Pauline?
Happy birthday, Peter.
That's all?
Yeah, that's all.
There he
birthday
is.
Birthday boy with Uncle Jim.
His favourite Uncle Jim.
He's my only uncle, isn't he, Jim? Oh, no, sorry. I didn't mean that.
I thought it was Crete.
No, that was concrete. Kip,
this is the chef's meal.
The sequel to the chef one. This is the chef two.
And what about the chef's assistant over there?
Have a look at what he's done.
This is the lovely.
This is the caterer.
Chef. Mr. Chef.
Have a look at this.
Would you like to say happy birthday to Peter for his 40th?
Happy birthday, Pete. 50 roasts on the way.
That was confirmed by Alice today, Kev.
50 roasts.
I'm the heir apparent.
That's his first.
40-year-old kiss. No, I got one this morning. Won't go into that, darling. Sorry about that.
Here's the chef's assistant. Would you like to say happy birthday to the chef?
Happy birthday to the chef.
To Pete.
Happy birthday, Peter.
Honey, cousins, nothing. No.
No.
Janie.
Yeah.
Are you going to say happy birthday to your dad? Come and go back and say.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. Oh, now you have to show. You have to turn to the video and say that.
Happy birthday,
Janie. Oh! Listen, Janie, what have you got to say about your dad? Have you got any sort of funny stories to tell about your dad? What do you think? What do you remember most about your dad? If I said the word dad to you, what's the first thing that comes into your mind?
Dad? I don't know.
No, there must be something. Can you tell, what's the funniest thing you remember about your dad?
He's 20.
Is he mean?
Yeah. No, he's not. He's alright.
He's just alright.
He's really good. He's excellent.
He's excellent. Excellent.
He's gorgeous and I didn't make him.
Trish. Oh, here's Trish at the oven. Trish, would you like to say anything about Peter?
Penis.
Go back.
I was at his 16th. I was at his 25th.
What are we talking about here?
I don't know. 25th. I was at his 35th. And here I am.
I should hope so.
And being Camilla. Ben, what do you got to say about Dan?
No.
What do you think of your dad? Yeah, now we're on. See that red light? It's on. So what have you got to say about Peter?
He had a dog named Mocha.
What was his dog's name?
Mocha.
Mocha. Mocha. It's pretty close.
We had a photo taken on our front door.
That's right. And have you seen those photos?
I went to the morgue and I couldn't find it. I think we gave it to him.
Yeah, that's right.
He came over one day to afternoon tea.
And who was there?
We gave it to him.
That's right.
I used to love that dog.
But what about, forget about Mocha, what can you remember about Peter?
He's very well behaved.
I'll come back to you first. Come back to you.
I remember when he was going to get married and his mother introduced him to this lovely girl. And he said to me, I can't get married. I need to go and get a job. That's what he said to me. And he just left to go.
And did you give him a job?
And I said to him, will you just get married and leave yourself with him?
That's what you said. Right.
And he was the most delightful man that I ever knew in the Dixon family.
Oh, right, okay. That's probably fair enough, because there wasn't many polite boys in the Dixon family, wasn't there? No, but there wasn't many other polite boys in the Dixon family. Yeah, he wasn't very polite, was he, Frank? No, that's right, yeah. Yes. They were. I thought they were.
Yeah, well, they were. And that little jacket, never got to look inside, but she was a lovely girl. She could be a man.
He could.
That's
right. Well, listen, we'll go over to Uncle Purse now. Now, Uncle Purse, you've been one of probably the all-time great photographers of all time, and were there on that famous Sunday taking those photos or handing the camera over. What can you remember about Pete?
Dad.
We're always very pleased to have him coming to visit us.
Yeah, well, you mustn't have had much company if that was the case.
Yes, we used to enjoy seeing his dog. The dog used to come around and never spoil the atmosphere or the lawn. A very polite dog. I'm a very polite man. Now, I have no further comment to make to the press, because he might see his solicitors and instruct them to take legal proceedings against me for breaching all the confidences about what a good boy he was when he was.
You must have known him. All I can tell you, you must have known him very well.
This ends the message.
So, okay. Now, what have you got to say about Peter?
Oh,
you got it.
I don't dare say anything else.
There's Jackie Dixon. Jackie Dixon, what have you got to say about your dad?
Stop touching
him. He's very happy. Very happy indeed.
Yeah, but is he always happy?
Yes, when he's drunk.
Chef!
Chef!
He's happy again.
Yeah.
What is that?
Uncle David.
Uncle David with his tricks.
Or anything like that, but
more.
Get fucked.
M-double-O.
No, it's
hello, Uncle Prickless. Hello, Uncle Prickness.
Is it M-double-O-R-E?
Hang on.
Sensational, Dave. Sensational.
Where are we going?
We're ready. We're ready.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Okay, Andrew. What have you got to say about Pete on his 40th?
Oh,
a quick one. Invited,
oh,
yeah,
my God, father, I don't have to answer this question, do I?
Has he got an invite?
What about? No, he's okay, I suppose.
Just okay.
Okay, yeah. He's 40.
Look. What about the chef over here? What do you think of the meat tonight?
Oh, it's beautiful, Kev. Magnificent.
We'll be sick for the rest of the week, I reckon.
Listen, is it true that you play tennis with the host's wife, Andrew?
More than tennis.
Apparently she's got her Monday nights free at the moment.
Yeah.
Johnny.
Oh, Kev.
What have you got to say about Pete?
Pete who? Whose party is it? Oh, look, one of the finest men.
One of the finest men,
yeah. That's
okay,
right.
Thanks, one of the Kev. Finest men. Jules, you've got to say hello to Pete.
Hi, Pete. Great invitation, lovely.
Right, okay. Moving right along. He's one of the greatest, all-time greatest.
This flaring here, sorry. Yeah. Sorry about that. Happy birthday, Diggo. Is that all?
Is that all?
Yeah.
Is that all you've got to say?
Yeah.
After all that practice.
Sorry, Nick Quinn.
I know Nick Quinn.
Happy birthday to Peter Dixon. Happy birthday.
Joy, what have you got to say to Pete? On his birthday.
I can't wait till your 80th, Peter.
Is that all? Have you got a big kiss for
and
him?
And hopefully I won't have to work at it.
That's very... Now, who have we got here?
Tony McCarthy.
Tony McCarthy.
And I used to go to school with Pete Dixon. I can tell you a few stories about Peter Dixon.
Yeah, can we have one of them?
No.
Oh, come on,
no.
Tony.
No, we slept in the same dormitory together.
Not in the same bed?
No.
Okay. Yeah, we're here.
Happy birthday, beautiful!
It's not David's birthday.
No, but this is the Peter's birthday, isn't it?
That's right, it's right.
He'll remember me.
Have you got anything to say to Pete on his birthday?
Just a happy birthday.
Is that all? What's your name?
Penny.
Penny. Hi, Penny. And who are you?
I'm Veronica. Welcome to the club, Peter.
You don't look 40, Veronica. Have you got anything to say to Peter on his birthday?
I think he's probably one of the most demented bastards I've ever known, and I think the only safe place for him is somewhere behind bars, actually, yeah.
Behind bars.
Over there.
Yeah, that bar there, bars. The bar there was full of grog.
Now, what have you got to say about Peter? Who have we got here?
My name's Peter as well.
Oh, right, we won't hold that against you.
No, I want to know what his friend Peter Mortimer was doing in the Baldwin News Agency this morning with a millionaire magazine open, but inside it he had Playboy instead. He was trying to conceal the fact that he was reading Millionaire magazine, but he had actually all these very clothless females there that he was poring over.
I reckon he learnt that off Peter Dixon.
Yeah, I'm sure he learnt that.
Have you got anything to say to Peter?
Oh, Peter, you're the greatest as always. Don't worry.
Okay, we're moving right along here. And who have we got here?
I'm Don Leaney.
Don, here we've got Don. Would you like to say anything to Peter on his birthday?
Anything to Peter? No, I had lunch with him yesterday and I think we said everything we had to.
You didn't take him over to the pub?
I took him over to the pub.
And you were the one who, every time we went to the toilet... He had a full glass?
No. I had trouble getting out of there. He wanted to stay.
Right, yeah. Dixon's are like that. Now, who have we got over here?
Bruce.
Severin. Yeah. Have you got anything to say to Pete on his birthday?
Oh, I don't think of anything witty.
Rude.
Yeah, that's right. Now, I just wish him all the best. Another 40 years and all that.
Right.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Elizabeth Flynn. I'm Bruce's wife. A Fletcher and Parker adjunct. It's been a pleasure being a friend of Peter's and Trisha's, and wish him all the best for the future.
Oh, very well. That's the nicest things anyone's said. It's good to see, Pete, that someone could say something nice. Who have we got here?
Hi, I'm Robin Doherty. I'm married to Ian Doherty, who works with Peter, so I'd just like to welcome Peter to the best generation around.
Right. I'm Tom Ryan. I work with Peter at the moment. And
at the moment, what have you got planned? Plans, Tom?
No plans.
Has Pete
I don't know. I'd just like to say that no one would like to go into the toilet after Peter at work because there's no point.
Right. Yeah, well...
Yeah, can she tell you everything?
What?
Hello.
Hello.
What's your name?
Sally.
Sally, you work with Pete?
I do. I'm his now, receptionist.
And what have you got to say? I'm Kevin. You saw me in
Kevin
the car.
Oh, yes. Great party time, yeah. Kev.
That's right. We've heard stories about Sally, haven't we, Dad?
She's the slut of the office.
Ah! Right.
That's...
He's awful.
R-rated.
Isn't he awful?
And what can you tell us about Peter? We heard stories about not to go in the toilet after Pete's been there. Do you go into the toilet?
Yeah, we're doing Scud missiles.
Scud missiles.
Scud missiles.
Do you go into the toilet after your dad's been there, Ben?
No.
Don't.
Good. Good.
Don't ever do that.
Have you got anything else to say to Pete on his 40th?
Oh, look, go on a diet.
Yeah. Okay, let's move in right along here.
Hello.
Hello.
Happy birthday, Pete. Happy birthday.
Is that all?
What more should there be? He's old now, isn't he?
He is. Brian. Now, yeah, Brian, I've got a famous story to recount.
Oh, yes.
Trisha's 21st.
Trisha's 21st.
Do you remember Trisha's 21st?
But I thought we're here to talk about Peter's 60th birthday.
Sorry. That's right, yeah, but probably one of the greatest occasions when Pete got stuck into that cold duck.
Pete doesn't get stuck into cold duck. He's an animal lover from way back. He wouldn't dare have a go at a duck.
Now, do you remember that phone call the morning after Trisha's 21st, Brian?
No. Are you going to tell me about that?
Yeah, no. If you don't remember it. Yeah.
This is a very sobering job.
I know that. Hey, Dave, I've done it. Okay, moving right along, Ra.
No, keep going.
Come on, Ra. What have you got to say to Pete on his birthday?
I think he's lovely, don't you?
Do you think so?
The wrinkles are showing.
Oh, come on. Got to get right on Ra here. Okay, moving on. Who have we got here?
Des.
Des.
I'd just like to tell Peter that the girl next door, Rebecca Stevenson, who he left behind when he was due to pick her up for school 10 years ago, is still waiting for him.
Right, okay then. Now, Pete, we're not at the bloody learned answer at the moment. We've got Kerry O'Brien.
No. Good luck.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, we're in the past here, Kez.
What was that?
We're in the past here.
Oh, no,
now, what have you got to say?
Happy birthday, Pete.
Have you got any funny stories to tell about... Now, come on, Kez.
No, none. No, not about fish and
chips. What about, you know, sort of when Trish first met Pete? What did she sort of say? You was her best friend, you know?
She hated him.
And then what happened?
Oh, well, she must have fallen in love with him.
Oh, well, Kez.
Yeah.
Just like everyone did with you.
Oh.
Okay, we're moving right along now, and we've got Julie Campbell.
Hello, everybody.
Julie Campbell, what would you like to say to Pete on his birthday, Julie?
It's nice to be here, Pete. I remember the 21st too. I'm an old-timer.
Yours or his, Julie?
Both.
Do you remember yours?
So do I.
Any stories about Pete?
Quick one.
Quick one? No. He was never a quick person.
Right, we've got to get to the bar because the cameraman... And here's Tobes.
G'day, Kev.
He looks like Fonz tonight.
I feel as old as Fonz too tonight.
I'll feel you later.
Right. Thanks, Kev.
Have you got anything to say to Pete on his birthday?
Pete, don't worry, mate. She's all downhill from here. It doesn't get any better.
Jan Tobin.
Happy birthday, Pete. It's a top night. Top night.
Get out of the bloody way. Now, listen, can we have some beers for the barman and the cameraman and the light man, not the barman.
Ah! I saw that. It's your shout.
It's on trial by video. Come on. Okay, over here. While our beers are coming. Glenn, what have you got to say to Pete on his 40th birthday? Because we know how good you are behind the camera.
I don't know.
Oh, come on, Lynn. You look so lovely.
I'm telling sort of the first story when I first met Pete.
Yeah.
Were you there at that dinner party? When I'd come down, from Queensland with Matt's about 3 weeks old, were you there?
Was I there?
Yeah, were you?
Where at?
And I got stuck into the liqueurs.
Hang on a sec. No, I don't know, that one. And you didn't get a bit molly, did you?
No, the first thing that happened, I remember, is Pete and Trish were doing renovations in their bedroom.
All right.
Matthew fell off the bed. He was about 3 weeks old. And there was a chandelier on the floor, so that sort of nearly decapitated him. But after we sorted that out, went back to the table, got stuck into the liqueurs.
And it was a good night. You don't remember the rest?
No, but when I got home, I fed Matthew, and he slept for about 24 hours.
Good stuff. Now we've got... No, Jackie, doesn't she look gorgeous? How's our light going here? Hey, light man.
Jackie, what did you say?
What did you say to me?
I said Emily rang me before.
And what'd she say?
That all the boys are over at her house.
Oh, really? What did she say before the rang us?
She said friend.
Oh, well, we've got this confirmed. The 22nd of June 1991, Emily is Jackie's best friend.
Yes, okay.
We needed that. Who we got?
The kids aren't there.
Brennan. Now, Bren, we sort of remember a couple of months ago when you were 21, wasn't it?
That's right.
Pete got up and told a few stories. Have you got anything to sort of say back about them now?
I'm not about the story. I just want to say one thing. I'm just thinking today, I don't think there's been one time in 25 years that Pete and I have had words with each other.
Well, if you've known each other for 25 years, you better start speaking to him. Well, you speak in tongues.
No, I don't think there's ever been a time that we've had a bit of an argument or something, which is pretty strange because he's a bit of a... he can be a bastard at times.
Oh, look, Trish told me that. Trish, you know, we've sort of got that on video, that Pete being a bastard, but okay, moving right along, we have to go over to... Now, what have you got to say about your favourite brother, and I'll hone that in, your favourite younger brother.
Youngest brother.
Not your favourite youngest brother, yeah, we'll leave it that. Is it his 40?
Yeah. I'd say, look, it would probably only yesterday when I remember he used to lock himself in the back dunny at...
this is the second toilet story we've had about him.
Oh, is it? Well, this is a particular... It wouldn't be all that long ago. He used to lock himself in the back toilet at Burke Road, obviously having a John Bull. That was only... It seemed like yesterday.
It did. Now, what about his Uncle Dick? My Uncle Dick, my godfather, what have you got to say about your youngest brother, your favourite youngest brother, on his 40th birthday?
He's all right, but he's not as good as you because being my godson, I've got to put you up front.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
But then again, Peter, on the other hand, you shouldn't call him a dirty old man.
No, because he's not like you yet.
No. On his birthday because he's not old.
He's not.
No, he's not. Old.
He's only a young boy. A beer. Okay. Jenny.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Jenny the spunk.
Jenny, at Pete and Trisha's wedding.
Yes.
Jenny and I were partners.
That's right.
And I introduced Jen to Auntie Agnes.
And I called her Auntie Ag. And she got
disgusting,
very upset.
Yes, and she was telling me about that in before, and she hasn't forgiven you.
Stiff.
That was what Pete had. And pub talk.
Yes,
grotty. What have you got to say about Peter?
Oh, he's a lovely guy.
Now, going back all those years ago at Edgevale Road, I mean...
Edgevale Road, Stirling Street.
No, off Stirling Street, 32.
That's right.
32.
Yeah.
That's how old you are, Miss Jen.
That's
32,
right.
Yeah.
I love you, Kim.
When Pete, you know, when Trish first met Pete.
Yeah.
Did she used to dream about him?
About who?
Pete.
Peter who?
Or was it Sam? What did she say about... Cut it!
What did she say about Pete?
What did she used to say about Pete when she first met him?
He was a spunk.
And did you try and talk her out of it?
No.
Who tried to talk some sense into her then?
You did!
To her, yeah. Didn't work. Okay, do you want to say anything to Pete on his birthday?
Happy birthday, Pete.
Do you love him?
I love you, Pete.
Okay.
We just
bypasses.
There you go.
Well, as good as you, and you feel good.
Okay.
How are you?
Right. Yeah.
Over here to Andrew Downey.
Hello, how are you?
What have you got to say about Pete on his 40th birthday?
What have I got to say? I just can't believe it. I cannot believe for 1 minute that he's made it to 40. With the lifestyle that man's led, I really can't believe how he's made it this far.
Do you know much about his lifestyle, Andrew, in the past that you'd like to bring up?
No, not a lot, unfortunately. You'd know more than I would.
No. Moving right along. Now, here's the Rosebud crowd.
Oh, no, well, actually, Alan J. Rickaby, my very special friend from Magnetic Island, Queensland, Billy J. Fields.
William Tavistock Fields.
William Tavistock Fields.
Going back to Rosebud all those years ago.
We're not actually going back to Rosebud.
You're not?
No.
Well, just move your minds back there.
Could I recite a little bit of poetry, which I think sums up the whole...
You
I'll
can.
Recite a bit of poetry.
Right, I'll recite some poetry, which sums up...
On the hill.
Well, it goes something like this, a little bit of Shakespeare, and it's called The Flowers, and it goes something like this. Thank you for the flowers you sent, she said, and blushed and turned away her head. You were right and I was wrong.
Closer, David, closer, because...
Forgive me. So I forgave her, and as she walked through the evening hours, I thought to myself, what fucking flowers?
We have to leave. We have to leave shortly because we've got a 40th birthday party to go to.
Right, okay then. Now, Rick.
You know Peter Dixon, don't you?
Yeah, yeah.
If you had a comment about Peter Dixon's life.
If I had a comment about Peter Dixon's life, I wouldn't comment. Jude.
Oh, yes.
What have you got to say about Pete on his 40th birthday?
Come on.
What have you got to say about Pete on his 40th?
Remember.
Rice burger.
I can't talk.
Well, we'll come back.
Okay, sure.
What have you got to say about Pete? Just walk on by.
It's hot. It's no, I've got lots to
say.
No, it's not.
He's a boring old fuck.
Pete's always been a really kind-hearted friend. And he's always had the ability to have good fun but without hurting anybody, which is a really good thing.
Yeah, well, he doesn't love the Peter I know.
Lorraine Matthews, who used to be Lorraine Matthews, and we're going back in the past.
A while ago.
It was. What have you got to say about Pete?
He's just a really nice guy.
Don't you know him?
And he's a nice side.
Telling all these stories about Peter being a nice bloke.
Oh, they don't know him like I do, kids.
Just learn how filthy he is through just being a cameraman.
Yeah. Listen, do you ever follow after he's been done poos?
No, never. Never. Only if you've got the fan on, Kev. Why? Have you been there?
No, we've just had a few stories from his work buddies. Okay. Where are we?
Behind me.
We haven't had Jackie here.
We haven't had Di.
Yes, we have. We
haven't had Di.
We have had Di.
Have we?
Yeah. Turned off here. Jackie. Jackie.
Hi.
What have you got to say to Pete on his 40th birthday?
Happy birthday, Pete.
Edward.
What?
Edward.
Go get a beer.
Hey, Ted, did you bring your tapes?
Yeah, I did actually. They're in the car. They're in the car. No. I'm going home shortly.
Jeez,
it's too early.
You're a pain in the ass.
I know. Well, I won't let me taste anybody. Say something for Pete. What do I want to say for Pete? What do you want me to say?
What can you remember about Peter down at Rosebud, Edward?
Rosebud. I've got to tell you the funny story about Rosebud. I said to Judy before. Does that have to be in my mouth, does it?
Yeah.
Peter, there it go, young Peter. No, young Peter, when he went, he's 16 years of age, and he went down camping at Rosebud with all the Gilligans before he actually thought about doing anything with his wife, decided to go out and play a man about town with a feral cat.
And he really was a feral cat behind the tents where we were camping. There was a feral pussy down the back of the tents. Sorry, Dave. But he hit this feral pussy with half a brick. And the feral pussy wouldn't die. The feral pussy attacked Peter.
Moving right along. Okay.
I don't know, no. Peter. I don't know.
You have to say happy birthday to him.
Happy birthday, Peter.
Is that all?
And, well, all I can say is that Peter has got a lot to answer for in the way that he brought up his nephews.
I agree with that.
Freddy!
Yeah,
what have you ever said about Pete?
Oh, what you tell me, what will I say? I've known Pete for a long time.
And what's your Jimmy? Don't you move away?
No, I'll be just over the back fence, Kim.
No, Jim, what have you got to say about Pete? Come on,
Pete Dixon. What can I say about Pete? I mean,
what's your earliest memory?
I think it was pretty nasty that he had his birthday when he knew that Jeff Hyde wasn't going to be here. I reckon that's the slackest act I've ever heard of.
We have an interview here with the youngest Dixon. Oh,
what's the odds?
He looks more intelligent than in...
I'm well, thank you.
What have you got to say
then? Oh, I've known Pete for a long time. I remember his 21st. Actually, tonight we came down Burke Road, and I said to Pete, now, wasn't it somewhere around here we were at Pete Dixon's 21st? Now we're heading off to his 40th birthday. Yeah. A lot of water under the bridge.
Well, there you go. Looks were you at his 21st?
No.
Okay, thanks. Moving on. Now, I've got the aunties. Yeah, you've got to put that on pause. Moira.
Yes, hi, Kev. Oh, no.
Are you going to say happy birthday to this very good Jim? We've got this on tape, you serving this.
So what's different?
Thanks, Dal.
Thanks, Dal. Now, Moira, what have you got to say about to Pete on his 40th? Have you got anything?
No, I haven't, actually.
Battery's
just
down,
that
please,
he's...
Kev.
Oh, good.
Okay, stop. You.
Peace.
Okay. Come on, Pete. Hello, Murray.
Hi, Dave.
Are you enjoying the night?
I'm having a lovely time. You?
Oh, good. Oh, look, I'm having a ball, actually. I was behind the camera before. Can't even say it. A bit pissed. And I was having a good time, but the big line is...
What?
What can you tell
what
me about
Pete? What can you say
Peter?
About Pete?
What can you tell me?
Oh, look, I can't...
Kev, you're supposed to look in the eyepiece.
Sorry. Yours? Or the camera. I have never witnessed any of Pete's silly nonsense. I've heard lots of silly stories about him.
Yeah.
But I'm sure you've heard all of those anyway. But, no, look, I can't. I don't even know any secrets or anything,
he's
David.
He's just a little sickle here.
Okay. Yeah. So can I just say happy birthday?
Yeah, happy
birthday, Pete.
Look in there.
Happy birthday, Pete.
Okay, right. Here we go. Okay. So we got Denise Drysdale over here. She's gone.
Billy will.
There's a lot.
Wilma.
This is Peter's big night. What would you like to tell us?
Your little special story about Peter.
About Peter Dixon?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh.
Senior, not your son, you silly bugger.
I'm speechless.
You're speechless. Oh, I know the feeling. All these years to just be speechless.
Never speechless when you want to have a few words with me, do you?
Oh, okay. We've got a bit of an argument here. Yes, okay, that's not bad.
If you asked me to talk about Richard, I would have had a lot to say.
Well, that's original. What about you, Joe? Have you said anything about Peter?
It's a great opportunity to get together. Because we never see him otherwise.
Oh, yeah, what did you tell Peter himself?
Yeah,
this is his big night.
Right. Pete, we think you're terrific. And you just look as young as you ever did.
Does he feel as young as he did?
That's the camera, not me. Yeah. You don't
right.
talk to the camera.
That's right.
Sorry. I'm sorry, Jeff. I'm not doing a very good job. We'll move on here to somebody who knows a bit more about Peter Dixon.
Well, when I first met the young man, he wasn't quite as young because he was a bit older, but he was driving a rusty Jaguar, and now he's driving Mercedes, but he tells me he's not going as well as it used to, so I don't know what to think anymore. Next person.
He's always full of shit. Oh, sorry, tickles. I'll erase that.
Okay. Down here, we've got
a hungry lady who's
awesome. Sorry, who have we got this lovely lady here?
Sally Montalto.
Oh, hello, Sally.
How are you?
What have you got to say about Peter?
What have I got to say? He's been a real great friend.
I haven't known him very long. Really? But he has been a good friend.
Have you known him as long as I have?
No, I don't think so. No, I think you've known him a long time than I.
Oh, right. Well, how about something very special straight into Peter's eye there?
Oh.
How about wish him happy birthday or something?
Oh, yes. I do wish him very many happy returns of the day.
Do you like that, Kev? Okay. Now, here we have a very lovely lady. What's your name?
I'm Loretta.
Loretta. Loretta, what have you got to say about Peter?
Happy birthday, Peter.
That all? Is that all?
That's all.
Okay. You haven't got any special stories?
No, not a story.
Okay, right, that's fine. Move on. Kev, have you got someone here? Who? Viv. Hello.
Hello.
We're talking about Peter. It's Peter Dixon.
So?
Have you got something special to say to him?
I don't know what to say.
Well, you look right into that camera there. Pretend it's Peter.
Yeah.
What would you say to him tonight?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. That's it.
Very good, Viv. It is a special day, though. He's 40. He's an old man. He's one of us. You're only 40.
Of course.
Yeah, okay. All right, we're moving on. Here we go. Tony Campbell is here. What would you like to say about Peter Dixon, Tony?
He doesn't look like he did when he was young, does he? He's changed.
He was a little bloody dickhead.
Oh, he was.
Now he's a big dickhead.
But I mean, look at him here. Can you get a close-up of that? When he's got his Jungle Jim outfit on. I mean, you know, you contrast with that with the little slob that he is now. Big one.
Look at him, the bloody little poofter here. Look at that.
Look at the half-clad woman. Trish didn't know about that.
Oh, dear me.
It's marvellous how it changes, isn't it?
See you later.
Bye.
Okay. Francis. Francis George Dixon. Hello, Francis George Dixon. This is,
that is David James, I believe.
This is David James. And here we have Peter over there.
On the hop?
You've got me on the hop. Now I'm on the scotch.
Well, what we're doing is we're having a little talk about tickle here. What have you got? A little something very special and brief. You can
little
tell.
Special and brief
stand
about the old
about
hair.
Kev, about
the old hair. Dick and I inveigled him into the Beaconsfield Hotel round about 1979.
Right, yes.
And I said, this is your life, Tickle Hair.
Pickle Hair?
Tickle Hair.
Yeah, right.
This is your life. You should be in this industry, liquor industry.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
If you could pan up there and see that photograph.
Oh, there we are.
Of Francis George and Tickle Hair.
Yes.
With Ruby Brough and Ralph Sutton.
And that was...
two of the greatest... jazz performers
that
I've ever met in my life.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, Uncle Dick wasn't there to enjoy their repartee. But that is my little
bit to
say.
There
I could tell you a lot more, but my wife is watching.
And so is his. So is his. Okay. Moving on.
Okay. Why don't you move along and tape someone else?
Here we go.
We've got Susie.
Next people here?
I'd like Susie Hanley and John Dixon. Susie Hanley and John Dixon.
Will you tell your story, Susie?
I haven't got any stories to tell you.
I've always got a stick. Hang on, hold the phone.
It depends
what was that?
What were you saying? I said I feel sick.
Oh, you feel sick?
She said, what? You said you had a stick.
I thought you said, what's a stick? Exactly.
Oh, that's right.
All right, okay. Now, come on, no private. John, what are you bloody doing? Okay, fine. Now, come on, mate. Listen, leave the bloody babies alone and talk.
Uncle Tickley.
Look, Kev, will you hold the phone up?
Hello, Uncle Pete. What have I got here?
You're boring.
What are these? Do you recognise these, Uncle Pete?
Kevin! You're hopeless, Kev.
Well, come on, who else have we got? Look, who's holding this bloody phone?
I'm being told a delicate story.
All right. Look, the bloody thing. Hold it up.
Yeah, Johnny.
Right, okay. Yes, come on, Johnny.
He's hiding.
Okay. Are you still, is
You're
it
not
off?
Not really doing it.
He'd want to be. He's hopeless. Out of his.
Look at him, John Flinders.
John Dixon's off his island.
Yes, I am.
That wasn't as good the second time, was it?
No. Take two.
John Dixon's off his island. Hey, that wasn't as good the third time either. Anyway.
Buddy, I love my Uncle Pete very much.
Oh, that's good. You're the first person out of all this interview that's mentioned love, except me.
Oh, I'll say it.
To Kev tonight.
I love Uncle David too.
I told Kev I loved him.
Kev, did you say to Kev that you loved him?
Yeah.
And he couldn't handle it?
No, I didn't know. He was shocked.
Was he? Shocked.
Yeah. Look at him. He's pointing at my chest.
Did he get a stick?
I don't know. It looks. Did you get a stick, Kev?
It must be flaring if he's pointing it over to the light there. He's up his face. He's trying to film. He's CS. Yeah. CS. He's CS, is he?
Kev, this is the worst piece of bloody videoing I've ever seen in my life.
You haven't seen the bloody video, so just snap.
All right, come on. We're going to move on to...
Yeah, we've got...
Oh, okay.
What are we on,
You've got
Jim?
3 minutes, mate.
3 minutes.
Now,
three minutes.
Tell me the story about the car, you know, the new car. You know, we're all going to buy a new car. And I'm going to sit in the back seat.
Uncle Billy bought a raffle ticket in a car.
Dick Elder Dixon.
Big Dick.
Bought a...
Big Dick.
Well, I don't know about big, but anyway, they bought a horse, a horse,
yes,
you know,
yes.
for the dairy,
yeah,
carts,
yeah,
out of Coburg. And Nancy and I were home alone this day, and she said, "Is it a nice horse?" And I said, "Yes, it is, very nice. Just a minute, I'll go and get it." And I brought it into the kitchen.
Is that true?
That is true. That's quite true. I bought this bloody big mare, and she was about 17 hands high. And I brought her into the kitchen.
That.
And Nancy, I don't know to this day whether she dived between the legs with a child under each arm. But she got out of it, and she screamed out, "You stupid bugger, Jimmy. You would be the only one in the world would do a silly thing like that." And you know, that night, it almost kicked the stable down. It was a real kicker.
Oh, that's a good one. I haven't heard that story. Now, listen, Jimmy, are you going to introduce your bloody young spunk that you brought along to this party? Have you?
Pauline.
Yes, dear.
Don't tell them all how wonderful it is to be married to me.
It's going to be choked, hasn't it?
I didn't get invited to the wedding. Geez, you're an old bastard.
Well, it's a matter of fact. It was a shotgun wedding.
All right.
We kept it quiet.
Is that true?
Yes, indeed.
Jeez.
We've been waiting for the results ever since.
All right. Okay. All right. Well, that was pretty good. Hello. Oh, sorry. Oh, I should introduce you. I mean, why don't you introduce yourself?
Hang on to that microphone.
To Peter. No, don't introduce yourself. You're talking to Peter.
I've got my glass ready.
Peter, it's Peter's for you. What have you got to say? To Peter. There, he's there.
You just Peter. Put that away from his glass.
I think Pete's a nice guy.
Right, go on. Pete's a nice guy, yes. What else?
Hell of a good piano, man.
Yes.
Doesn't Barrack for Hawthorne.
All right, okay.
Okay,
story finished. What's your name?
Bruce.
Hi, Bruce. Hi, how are you? Sorry. My name's Pete Smith. Hi, Pete Buick. How are you, mate?
Going well, thank you.
And what do you got to say about Tickle Hairs bloody turning?
Fucking 40, mate. Well, he's same age as the rest of us, plus a bit more. Tickle Hairs are really... Mine's a bloke, except he can't play chess.
No,
he can't play. He thinks he can. What he does is, when you want to have a game of chess with Pete, he brings along 3 bottles of port. He waters down his and drinks half and fills you up the rest. That's how Pete wins chess. Dead set.
And then, what, does any beat you?
No, I always beat him after.
Goodbye, Mr. Buick. Okay, here we go, in here. Right along. Okay. There we have Denise Drysdale here.
Denise, say hello, Denise.
Hi.
Denise, you say hello to Peter. This is his tape.
Hi, Dicko. 40 today.
That's good. Kev, you're hopeless.
Watch the wrinkles. Not on the wrinkles.
Okay, moving
along.
Say, hello, this is Michael speaking.
I mean Michael.
Michael.
I'm sorry, Michael.
That's all right. Apology accepted. Hello, Peter. Am I talking to Peter Dixon on his 40th? Have a good day, Peter. And many more. You want me to keep going?
Yeah.
Oh, that's enough.
That's enough. Russ has got to the top.
Oh, good evening and welcome to the 9:30 News Update. How are you, Peter? Nice to see you. Happy birthday. See you later.
Very good.
Happy birthday, Pete. We miss you at Normanby Road, son. We need someone to stir up this council. Come back.
Okay, good one, good one, good one. Here we have this gentleman. You've been there, have you?
We've given, Pete. All our love.
I haven't. Happy birthday, Pete. God, funny lights a bit.
Are you used to the?
Are you pissed?
No, I'm not, but I'm lost for words.
What am I supposed to do? You know you're the lucky last. Mark?
Happy birthday, Peter, on your 40th.
Would you like another drink, Mark?
How do you enjoy playing solo with Pete, Mark? Very embarrassing. What did you get that? I said, did you hear that? I said, how do you like playing solo? Mark said, what did I say about playing solo? Yeah, I said, very embarrassing. Baby. Hey, Mr. Norman.
Happy. Young Joshua.
Oh, sorry. It's Pete's birthday, but I know Pete's got a little something for Trish. And when I mean little, I mean little.
Hang on, little.
What's that, Mark?
Little?
Yeah, little, you know. I was exaggerating before.
Good. I want to know how you enjoy playing solo with Pete.
With Pete? Yeah. Pete really gives me the shits, Trish. You know that?
He does.
He does. You know what I mean?
I do. Would you stop moving away and stand here?
I'm finished.
He's shy, Kim.
Camera shy.
Get the right light on you there, Pete.
Sorry, Russ Norton. No, there we go.
Well, I've already been on.
This is the man that loves the microphone.
I just gave the news update. It's about 3 minutes ago. It's a bit late now. Go to an ad break.
Do you want to get in your mouth? I've heard about your microphones.
It's a little tiny, isn't it? Very tiny little thing, isn't it?
I'm used
to the bigger jobs, really.
It's about the strength of the I think you're very rude.
What was that, Mark?
You're rude. That's it.
Oh, hello there. This is Peter's special tape. Have you got something special to say to him?
I just want to wish him a very happy birthday and hope he has a lovely night.
Oh, very good, very good. And
I've said my bit. This is.
That's Robin.
Happy birthday, Peter.
How are the horses, Robin?
They're still running. They're going great guns.
Good. You got anything to say to Peter?
You got me. No, I speak to him too.
Don't you know him? That's Peter there. Okay, that's fine.
No, I said all my bit before.
Okay, right, we're repeating ourselves here. We'll move along here. Can you interview me a bit? Just interview me now. Now, she didn't like being interviewed. Righto, here we go. We've had you. Les.
G'day,
Les, would you like to say something to Peter?
Yes, Peter, you can go and get fucked as far as I'm concerned, you bastard. Oh, no, I can't say that, can I? Very happy birthday, Peter. Thanks for making me look good for the last 4 years. Really appreciate it.
Jesus, tick away. Don't undersell yourself. Okay, what about Marky?
G'day, Uncle Prickless. How are you? Oh, I'm going to say g'day to the viewers.
Yeah, viewers. Have you already said it?
Have I said it?
I don't know. I can't hear you.
Good evening, everybody. I'm having a wonderful time.
Ah, very good.
Thanks, Uncle Peter, for all the food and the alcohol. I've been able to, get the camera on my face, but it's been a wonderful time.
Very good.
Happy birthday.
Very good. Goodbye.
I have to speak highly of my super tennis partner, you know, so I can't say anything bad about him. But I should remind Peter, when he's listening to this, watching this, when I came in tonight, I gave him a big kiss, which he may not remember, but I can recall probably nearly 40 years ago that I was around at Corkle Street, and he was only a baby, and I was nursing him, and his mother came in and said, "Now, he's got a cold, so don't give him a kiss today." And I'd already given him a kiss.
Hi, Joe.
Now,
you're going.
Going back another... Your big brother, Dick, has been telling me stories about when he came around, and he's established that he's 9 years older than me, and he had a billy cart. And was telling... Are you interviewing? That's all right, I'm just still talking, don't worry. So Dick was been telling me tonight how he used to put me in a billy cart and drive me up and down White Street. So there's a couple of generations. Happy birthday, Peter. And with a bit of luck, you might get a good tennis partner next year.
We're talking now. We were talking just before about when Peter was a baby, John was saying he was holding him. And your mother was saying something, but you were telling me one thing one day when John was a baby, and Auntie Molly, my sweet mother, brought him home to Dandenong Road, and you had a poem for him. I just wondered if you'd like to sort of repeat that poem for him now.
I remember that poem so well. It was about my son John. Went to bed with his stocking on. One stocking off and one stocking on. Diddle diddle dumpling my son John. I think I was about 5 years of age.
Well, John was six, so.
And can I tell you something about my young brother Peter?
Yes.
I was sick in bed with an ailment. My mother kept coming in the door, but always Peter first. And I used to say, "Mum, are you still here?" And this was June 1951.
Date?
Well, June, before the 22nd.
Right.
And I'm still in bed. I was sick with an ailment. And looking out the window, it snowed in Melbourne. For the only time I ever remember, the whole thing went white.
Yeah.
And I don't think Peter
three
had
wise men
anything to do with it. But I'm still in bed. Mum went and had Peter at Carbathon. And I'm still in bed. And she's come in and laid him beside me in the cot.
In the manger.
In the manger. Young Peter with his red carrot hair.
Okay. No, he wasn't. No, wait a minute. He's not supposed to be.
Right along.
Oh. Sorry, Frank. Moving right along. We've got the man himself here. 40 today.
Oh. I'm disappointed.
Got a cold. I hope he hasn't got a cold.
I'm disappointed that wasn't a tongue kiss. He didn't hear that, Jody.
Now, listen, what about... This is like old times going up to Broken Hill.
Oh, jeepers.
Bloody Broken.
Back in... when was it? Pete, you would have been 16.
You were 16 going on 70.
And David had been to court And he hadn't lost his license
when David pretended he was out of petrol. And he's got the foot on the accelerator. He's got, well, Kev, we're in the middle of nowhere. Kev is shitting himself. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? What are we going to do? Oh, Kev, we're bugging. We're bugging. What are we going to do? Oh, we might be able to get some petrol, some abos or something.
We're in between Broken Hill and Wentworth.
Yeah, that's right.
And
yeah.
Where we tried to shoot the cockies.
Yeah.
Oh, and then the car came along and bitched and said, don't shoot me.
What about the hotel, Kev? What was it about the hotel?
You stay in bed, you kids. I'm going down to Consum Chicks.
No, what about when we started, when we had to leave?
Yeah, and we had to get the wheels balanced.
But before that, what about you be there at...
The big thing was that I had to be there at 6:30.
Right.
And we were
going to Broken Hill, by the way.
Broken Hill. And this was Thursday night. This was all decided. And so I had to be there at 6:30. But the only problem was that I had a paper round. So we had to race up to the newsagent. And I asked if I could have a couple of days off from the paper round. He said, that's fine. As long as you can do the paper round tomorrow morning, I'll find someone else. No worries. So I got up at about 5 o'clock. And did my paper round because I had to be down at Burke Road by 6:30. So I'd finished my paper round about 15 minutes flat, and then I started walking down. And I had these two big bags, my luggage, walking down Burke Road, and my arms were just aching, and I just didn't want to put them down on the ground just in case. They'd bloody leave without me, because if I wasn't there, they're going to leave without me. So, I got to the sort of the bottom where the bars are, and I sort of put down for a minute, and I had a look, I'm running late. Picked up, and I sort of, it was just agony walking up, and here I get up the bloody Burke Road. No one was stirring. So then I wake everyone up. Bloody finally get out about, 7:15, we get out to the kitchen, and... having breakfast, and Uncle Dick, good old Uncle Dick, who was in his sick years, came out, looked at me, he goes, what are you bloody doing here? Get home and have your breakfast. But what a time, all those years ago. But
it was a good time.
Peter was a bastard good to me, because he's always bloody...
Pecking order, Kev. Pecking order.
I remember
pecking order.
One of the first times he ever
Nippy
came down.
Used to give me a hard time.
I'm like him. Go easy.
Paul,
when he came down to our place, and we were going back up to Burke Road, and there was this fire hydrant. He said, when I was coming down before, I saw these kids put some ice creams in this fire hydrant. I said, oh, really? And I was so colourable that I believed him. But he woke me up. He woke me up alive in about 5 minutes. But then this other time was that, we were really close, and then one day he met this girl called Trish. And then I got the arse then. But we were going up to Rosebud. We're going up the hollow up to Rosebud. And
Connery did. When I'm up at Buddy's school, I got the letters to prove it.
When I get up there, I'll give you a ring. Oh, I'm still waiting for that bloody phone call. Now, Peter, what have you got to say about your 40th years? 40 years.
Hey, you bastard. It's rumour, Kev. I'm 30. Gee, was that light's a bit bright. Johnny, cameraman and bloody light man at the same time. Well, I thank everyone for coming tonight. Did you come tonight, Kev? I hope you did. And it's been a lovely night. And I hope everyone said nice things about me. Not naughty rumours like Kevin Bolt. Seb? Kev, you're on.
Okay then, we're signing off now. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to
David.
Me.
Yeah.
What about the time at Burke Road, when you were peacefully out the back in your room, having a shower,
yeah.
Peter came in with his camera and took a photo of you.
Where is it?
Under the shower.
Well, where's the photo?
Well, he didn't have a film in it, but
what about,
you chased him through the house.
What about?
I don't remember that one, Kev.
What about Sue Smith and the bloody wetsuit?
Tell me.
The wetsuit. Nips had this lass, Sue Smith, who was in love with for 50 years. Anyway, he said, listen, tickly. He said, Sue's
get tickly, right? Say tickly, probably.
Tickly. Yeah. Sue's coming around tonight. And you better behave yourself. Because, and
that
make
was
sure.
Diane, was it?
No,
that was the first night Diane came around.
It was Sue.
Yeah,
I met Diane up the thing. Yeah. Up the thing. It was Sue. She said, and make sure. And make sure that you're dressed right, Nelly. Well, anyway, Sue comes to the door with Nips, and I got my wetsuit on. I just got this wetsuit, just the top of the wetsuit, not the bottom, just the top of the wetsuit. Well, he was totally pissed off.
All right, well, I can tell a little story about Peter. Now, it just reminded me, one day, Tickle Hair. Dressed up like, what do you, we've got a top hat, umbrella, dark suit, and we set him up, we said, we'll go, and...
Were there many of those umbrellas around? Were they umbrellas or umbrellas?
Umbrella, if you like. And Tickle Hair went to the front door of Burke Road, and we all knew not to answer it. Mum went and... went to the door, answered it, and Peter was all dressed up to the hilt, and Mum said, yes, and Peter said, oh, Mrs. Dixon? my name's Mr. Greenwood, and I'd like to come in here, and I'd like to speak to your children. oh, yes, Mr. Greenwood, come in. Remember that? I don't know. Yeah, that's what I
said. I was a friend of Paul's. Oh, are you? Oh, I remember you. She said, I remember you. You've been here a couple of times. Yes.
Yes, I've been here a few times. Yes, yeah, good to see you again, Mrs. Dixon. How are you? How's David? Yeah. Oh, very good. Very good.
She said about half an hour, she said, It's Paul!
What about the other time when Arnie Eileen was next door at the Hennessy's and Pete rang up at the Hennessy's and said, hello, Mrs. Christie. It's the PMG here. I believe that you've been having trouble with your telephone at Pine Grove. Arnie Eileen, not being anyone to sort of miss an opportunity, said, Yes, I have. And it's crackly and went on and on and on. And, yes, Peter said, yes. She says, well, listen, if you have any more trouble, tell Mr. Peter Dixon about it and he'll fix it. She said, Peter, you bastard! You bastard, Peter! And then she was in there one day, and Pete rang up, and so hello, Auntie Island, your favourite nephew here. Says, yes, who is it? Says, my name starts with R. Says, Rob. I backpad the way yesterday.
What about the?
What about with David? You know, going back to the.
Cleaner?
No, what about going back with the famous trip up to Broken Hill, and so Dave's, you know, Commander Court, And now he's gained his license. He hasn't lost his license. So we've gone up to Broken Hill and we've taken off, you know, at the early hours of the morning. But we got to Essendon and David wasn't happy with the bloody balancing.
A bit of a problem.
Oh, the bloody wheel. Now they're just unbalanced. So we call into this garage in Mount Alexander Road. And so we get the wheels balanced. So we're there for bloody three quarters of an hour and the bloke's, you know, whacking away. And so he finally comes out and we get off the jack and David's got a smoke in his mouth. Backing out and Peter's sitting beside him and then he goes, oh, that's no good. Bloody David spits his cigarette, bloody tickling, you bloody idiot.
Oh dear.
That was only the start of it. And then, I mean, I'm only a mere mortal, but we got to Bendigo and we had a salad sandwich for lunch. And they're the best salad sandwiches I could still remember.
No, absolutely, no, they're big.
But they weren't cut properly, so they were shit out.
Is that right?
They weren't cut properly, they had a little nick on the bottom. But it was a funny, funny times.
Well, there's one thing I must remember about Tickle Air. Is Paul and I were going into the city. We were about 14 or 15. And we were going into the city because that's where we used to meet all the chicks, you know. And Tickle Air said, I'm coming. And I said, no, you're not, you little shit. And he said, oh, I want to come. And he said, no, it wasn't Paul and I, it was Blackguard and I. And Blackguard said, I'll let him come. I said, he's not coming, the little shit. He'll really, you know, cramp our style. And, you know, and the last thing I was doing was walking down Burke Road, and particularly I was in tears, walked back to Burke Road, and I'll tell you what, I had a shit.
We didn't take you to the city tomorrow.
Well, we didn't meet any chicks either.
Pete used to take me. He even took me when he met Chantal.
Really? I don't remember that.
Oh, let's go back a few years, Nips.
Anyway, it's Chantal. Not my buddy, 40 Tickle Air. It's yours, so we'll talk about it.
Fantastic stuff.
Any other memories?
Memories.
I think it's about time we went and had a drink.
All right.
Okay. And we get the dancing music going because David and I have done those bloody tapes.
I heard. It's only a rumour, though.
Actually, David didn't. Bastard.
Yeah, bloody. But what have you got to say about Nips?
I reckon he's a shit.
Ah!
Well, you should really mean that, don't you, Kev?
But I love you, Dave.
I love you too, Kev.
Thank you for the organisers tonight. Bag of poofters.
Okay. That's it. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Petey.
Happy birthday. Wouldn't it be funny if that bloody thing hasn't worked properly all
of it? Yeah.
Oh, that's real.
I've got enough. See you later.
Okay, bye.
Hang on.
You missed the piggery, mate.
We haven't got Gaz on the video. And
it's been a rock and roll night.
Have you been rocking, Frank?
Yep.
Gaz, who sings this song?
Kev. Summer, autumn, etc, etc.
Months, who sings this?
Oh, I would never have
heard. I gave you the clue.
But what have you got to say about Pete on his 40th birthday, Gaz? Now, what can you remember about Pete? Because some stories. They don't have to be funny.
Well, okay, no funny stories. About Pete's...
Pete's life. Yeah, no. When's the first...
About his orange.
His orange.
His orange.
Let's hear it.
About my orange. Well, your arm. Yes. Should really have been a banana, but no, as we call it, an orange. I don't know what.
Tell us more about it.
Orange. Tell. I think it was my orange, actually. Playing cricket one day. Big bowl. Beauty got me right in the orange. We're certainly bloody orange happy. Hit me there.
Day the opposite source.
Very close to them.
That is painful.
Yeah, you've dropped this off.
That bloody pain.
We still love him even though he's 40.
Is that all?
Yeah.
What can you say to a man who reaches 40?
That's right. It's all been said.
Life begins at 60.
I reckon life begins at 60.
You know, I reckon life begins when you're born, or when you conceive. That's what I reckon.
We'll leave that deep and meaningful right there.
Right to the point.